Good morning students, we will see about flotation. We know that whenever a body floats, then there are two forces acting on a body. One is the weight of a body, which will be acting in the downward direction, and the other force is the upward force, which is also called the upthrust exerted by the liquid. This is how it will be if we consider this as a container filled with water, and this is the body floating. So there will be two forces acting. One, I said, the force will be the due to weight of the body, which will be acting at the center of gravity of the body, and center of gravity is the point where the body, due to which the body remains in the equilibrium state. This is the point where the weight of the body acts. Now another force that will be acting is the force due to the liquid, which is called the upthrust, and this upthrust will be acting at the center of buoyancy, and center of buoyancy is the center of the displaced liquid. So if you consider this as the center, this is the immersed part, and the center of immersed part is this point, which is the center of buoyancy. So upthrust will be acting at this point. Now in order to remain the body in the equilibrium state while floating, the center of gravity should always remain inside water. Because if it remains outside, then in that case the maximum part will remain outside, and due to which the body may be blown over to one of the sides. So it's necessary for the center of gravity to remain inside water when the body floats, whether partially or completely. Now we know that there are three cases when the body weight is greater than the upthrust, body will completely sink. It will sink into water. Second is the case when weight of a body is equal to the upthrust, the body floats with all its part inside water. This is how the body floats with all its part inside water. And the third is the case where the weight of a body is less than the upthrust. In this case, the body floats with its some part inside the water and some part outside. So only that portion of the body will remain inside water, due to which the weight of the liquid displaced becomes equal to weight of the body. So some portion will be inside, some will be outside. This we have. Then we have the relation between, one relation has to be derived, which is V upon capital V is equal to density of solid by density of liquid, where small V represents the volume of immersed part of a body, capital V is the total volume of the body, dS is density of solid, and dL is density of liquid. How to derive this? According to principle of flotation, upthrust is equal to weight of a body. Upthrust can be written as volume of a body immersed, which we have taken as small v, then density of liquid into g, and weight of a body will be total volume into density of solid into g. Now cancelling g, we can bring both the volume to one side and the density to the other, we will get that relation. So this is what we have derived. This is very important to solve the numericals. So next class I will show you how to solve numericals based on this relation. Thank you.